right, skinny time. Begin with the Biebs.
Again.
Justin Bieber may be eyeing a mansion in Atlanta, but his prospective neighbors did not have any part of it.
Oh, no. Angry residents in the affluent neighborhood of Buckhead are holding a protest this morning outside what may become the Biebs' new digs. A protest Justin Bieber moving to Buckhead Facebook page has been created, and it has already garnered hundreds of supporters.
And the 19-year-old superstar is also persona non grata in his California neighborhood of Calabasas, where he's accused of egging a neighbor's house. Remember all those instances where he was allegedly speeding through the neighborhood? Keyshawn Johnson even confronted him on one of these things, apparently. Well, he's also taken the high ground in Atlanta, tweeting, "I will continue to meet hate with love." You know, this is what happens when you get a bad reputation.
Well, exactly. And it's been one thing after another.
There's
that wasn't
been a
an
lot
isolated
of drama
incident
in that California community.
I cannot blame those neighbors. I wouldn't. Can you imagine living next door to Justin Bieber?
I mean, I wouldn't want a sports car running 100 miles and through my neighborhood, which is what some of those neighbors there in California were alleging. So, yeah, we'll see.
All right. Well, moving on to Alec Baldwin, who, not for the first time, is saying he is done with public life. And in a very long essay in New York Magazine titled, "I Give Up," Baldwin denies being homophobic.
All right, that part of his latest rant stemming from a run-in with a photographer here in New York late last year. The photographer accused Baldwin of using an anti-gay slur, but Baldwin denies doing so.
Among the other revelations in Baldwin's essay, he says he can't live in the Big Apple anymore because it's full of paparazzi and people with camera phones that invade his privacy. So he says he has to move his family to Los Angeles for more privacy. And he says he despises the media in a way he didn't think possible. Lastly, Baldwin says his essay is the last time he's going to talk about his personal life in an American publication ever. Can we please hold him to that?
You know what? Never say never. I got a feeling he's going to move back to New York someday, and we're going to hear a lot from him.
Well, and is it just New York that has people with smartphones taking pictures and paparazzi?
I guess in Los Angeles you have these, you know, these gated communities, these walled communities where you have a little more protection, at least when you're at your home, I'm guessing. All right, listen to this. More changes at CNN. Piers Morgan's primetime show has been canceled because of low ratings. Former tabloid editor in the UK, Morgan took over for Larry King 3 years ago.
Morgan told the New York Times that CNN's audience has tired of hearing a Brit weigh in on American cultural issues. Not clear when the last show will air or whether Morgan will remain at CNN.
I tell you what, a lot of times I take a break in my office and I watch ABC programs too, but I watch some CNN sometimes, and I've come to enjoy Piers Morgan's show.
Yeah, I watch
working
the
this late night shift, so that's a shame.
All right. Well, former Food Network star Paula Deen, on the other hand, is on the rise. At a food festival in Miami Beach this weekend, she rode across the stage on the back of another Food Network star, Robert Irvine, telling the crowd she is, quote, back in the saddle.
Back in the saddle. Hey there. All right. Last summer, Deen lost her show and endorsements worth millions of dollars. Her former employee accused her of racial discrimination and sexual harassment. But earlier this month, she announced that a private investment firm is investing more than $75 million to finance her comeback.
And I guess, why was she on his back? I still don't get it.
Come back. Topping the skinny bonus round, Miley Cyrus pushing the limits, so to speak, again in the middle of her performance here in Los Angeles this weekend. She goes and gives a good friend a kiss. A real good smooch, that friend. Katy Perry. Kiss straight on the lips.
Oh boy, a fan posted the moment on Instagram.
Is this shocking anymore? I'm not really sure. Isn't this kind of like a 5 years ago shocking moment?
Yeah, I think it's just, you know, another thing to get some attention.
Yep.
All right, well, afterward, Katy tweeted out another photo that even Miley seemed to be a little surprised at what she had just done. Katy covered her mouth and she added the words, "I adore you, Miley Cyrus." So good friends, maybe very, very good friends. I don't know. That's not how I greet my buddies. But they are very good performers.
It gets you on TV and gets you in the magazine. Mm. So, yeah, I think I would imagine they're just friends.
I think so, too. Yeah. All right. Well, from the girls to the boys and the rumor that brought a tear to John Mueller's eye.
My daughter loves this band, One Direction, right?
Yeah, this rumor that One Direction is breaking up. Well, this morning, word that it isn't true. Rest easy. They're staying together. TMZ reports that band members are doing some solo writing and comparing notes for what will be the final versions of new songs.
Plus, Harry Styles told a British newspaper that they are just taking some time off to visit family and they'll be rehearsing again soon, but the biggest proof they are staying together They still owe three more albums on the contract with Simon Cowell's label, so no way they can break that deal. Simon is a master. These guys are huge, and Simon is the man.
And why would they break up now? Why,
yeah, they're doing great. They have really nice voices, by the way. They're good singers.
I think you're a fan. You blame it on your daughter, but I think it's daddy
fan.
Or who's
All
a
right,
fan.
It's official. Yeah. All right, just 6 days until the Oscars, by the way, and there was another big award show this weekend, the NAACP Image Awards.
Oprah was there, and she took the opportunity to snap what she says is her first selfie. Looks like maybe she needs a little practice.
Yeah, what happened?
But there she is with Mandela, Long Walk to Freedom star Idris Elba. A nice effort, I guess. We'll give her an A for effort, but maybe she'll snap some more as she goes and maybe actually get her whole face in there next time.
Yeah. All right, let's take a look at some birthdays this morning. Celebrity birthdays, movie and TV actor Abe Vigoda, very much alive, 93 years old. Remember Fish from Barney Miller?
Yeah, country star Sammy Kershaw celebrates 56, and Sex and the City's Charlotte Kristen Davis is 49. Happy birthday
and
to all.
Great,
yeah, she's gorgeous.